1 o'clock in the morning.
Dude, I was fucking...
Yeah, we got a podcast to shoot. We're fucking playing around on the lane.
I was waiting for you to get your shit fixed.
My shit's been fixed, bro.
Dude, your shit.
My shit's fixed, bro.
What?
WASD ended up, bro. You run out of ammo, dude?
Yeah, dude.
That fatal click again?
Gotta reload, bro.
We already agreed, bro. We're shooting a Shoot the Poop podcast, folks.
Yeah.
Then.
Shoot it.
You dude, got we're shooting it right now. We're on episode 33.
Shoot it. Are we shooting it, dude?
And you're shooting it on
fucking your shoot it, dude.
You're shooting it.
Did we just shoot it right there, dude?
We're just shooting it, dude.
Holy shit.
It's like some Saturday Night Live intro shit, bro.
This summer. Oh, you're not going to upgrade it? Yes, dude.
Oh, you ain't upgrading nothing, dude.
I'm upgrading my secure, dude.
Dude, you're secure.
Yeah, I'm insecure. Dude, that's why I got to upgrade it.
Dude, Shane. Dude,
hold on. Oh, yeah. Fuck yeah. Fuck yeah.
That's what it's like trying to work with TT over here.
Get the fuck. What do you mean, dude?
Out of your target.
I am the best. Listen, you. I was waiting on you. Yeah, and then bro. I don't know how to get out of here. Okay. It's not that I'm... I just don't know how to do the things, which is like it's why it takes.
But we're doing things sometimes. We don't know how to do. The things.
Right.
I also don't know how to do things, and
you know better than I do, though.
Yeah,
for sure.
I feel like certain aspects.
Is that mic right?
I feel like testing. More on my side. At
testing.
Point,
okay, so yeah.
I feel like we're better off.
Hello, hello.
Four.
Are we there?
I think we're there, dude. That sound is not being stopped.
What? Dude?
Okay. We're just covering the fan noises to try to up our audio games.
No, we were trying.
Just tickling the ball of the mic, dude.
Listen to it. It's kind of... That's a satisfying little fucking...
Sounds like a zipper, dude. It's a zipper noise you hear in the tarks, dude. And somebody's looting the bags.
Somebody's looting a duff bag, dude. Go shoot him.
Dude.
Everything can't relate to Tark, dude. The people are sick of the Tark cot, dude. They hate it, bro. They hate it.
How
dude.
Jealous are you right now, dude?
What? That's fucked up, Doug. For real. Go get Cheyenne shit, because I'm pissed. Like, this is not acceptable, dude.
Oh, man. Broke ass, vape looking ass.
Dude. I'm for real. I'm about to burn this fucking stove in the stew, dude. I'm about to light it off the can.
Right in front of your brand new compute, dude.
Right in front of
bring all that smoke right into the fans. Just draw it in.
I will. Yeah, fuck dude. It, dude. Yeah. Worth it, dude. About to crack this bitch.
Dude. Why? You got some nice ass looking Stokes, dude.
Dude, let's fucking smoke some Stokes, dude. Let's take this podcast outside, dude. When was the last time you had a fucking bonfire?
I don't
dude?
Think we have the capabilities right now, barely, of filming a podcast indoors. Okay.
You can't tell them that, dude. They're going to unsubscribe.
We've been doing it since January. We barely got the capabilities.
This is a professional podcast, dude. Yeah,
completely professional.
We have the most.
Professional.
There's no. This is not smoke and mirror.
No.
This was not filmed in a Hollywood
lack
basement.
Of smoke
dude. Yeah. No, that's fuck. Stop. Dude, you're freaking egging me on, bro.
Oh, man. Fucking. Why are you sucking so hard, dude?
You're gonna have to fucking. I need that oral fixation, dude. Because my fucking vapes broke,
oh,
dude.
Man.
Oh, I'm a fucking fiend, man. But no, not really. But since I'm about to drive to the fucking gas station and get some square. But the fucking Newport Hundreds. That's what you gotta smoke, dude. Okay. If you're not smoking Newport Hundreds, you're a bitch. Like, that's where it's at with the SIG game.
Blessed. Smokes I saw you smoking, though, were the Lucky Strikes, dude.
That's different, though. That's a whole different...
Yeah, dude.
But yeah, I always did like the Newport Hundreds, man, because it's 100, so, like, you get a longer smoke.
Yeah.
It's more satisfying, because I always felt like shorts, which is just, I guess, a regular-sized cigarette,
yeah,
is... It burns too quick, and then you it starts tasting like it's burning too quick.
Yeah.
And, like, if I'm smoking a cig, I'm smoking a cig to sit there and relax and enjoy it or whatever. And so, like, I like the little bit of extra burn to it. Plus, Newport Hunters, dude, as ghetto as that shit is, bro, it's the most satisfying, hardest-hitting menthol. Like, we get all the menthol shit on these little motherfuckers. Like, it just, it sounds homosexual, but the way that it hits the back of the throat, dude, it's more satisfying than other things. Like, you don't feel like you've had enough until so. But that's what it was, dude.
Literally so diehard Newport 100s, bro.
I know.
You had the matching shirt.
I had the matching shirt. You guys can see it on Instagram still to this day, dude.
It is.
I had a faux hawk, too, at the time. You know, like, that's just how it goes. That's drip. You want to talk about drip, dude? I fucking invented it.
You had the drip, dude.
I had the drip, dude. I had to go see a doctor.
Yeah, exactly.
Penicillin. Yeah. 3 weeks later. Yeah. I'm recovering still, but either way...
Still claims he got it from a toilet seat.
Listen, dude.
Truck stops.
You don't know the types of people that I work with. So, like,
you do. That's the problem.
Exactly. So that's a fucking alibi if I've ever heard one.
Yes, it is. But you did not work with them at that point.
Bullshit.
What do you mean? When you rock the Newport 100 fucking polo, dude.
Listen, you can rewrite canon these days. So, like, it's all just at the end of the day, it's what... We feel the story should be.
Yeah.
It's not what the story is.
Yeah, dude.
You know?
Yeah.
What are you doing?
I'm doing some stuff, dude.
With what?
I'm
something that could potentially...
potential batteries.
Create a story in the future.
Potential videography. Technology.
That's too much syllables for me.
It is. For most of our viewers, I'm sure. But what I'm really talking about is I'm charging the new batteries that I've received.
New bats, dude.
For...
That's like a baseball team new that technology. Just got sponsored.
That is old-ass technology. Sponsored by the Terribly Tactical.
What?
GoPro Hero.
You bought the bats.
I did buy the
bats. But I'm bringing it up with the super GoPro, new, relevant, latest, highest speed, lowest drag technology.
GoPro 3.
GoPro.
Pretty sure they're at the Hero 10 by now.
It's the Hero 3, dude.
It's the Hero 3, dude.
That bitch came with a cape. So, like, I'm telling you, dude.
But.
I'm telling you, man.
Now, I've finally gotten to resetting it.
Since... Which explained to the people what the problem was. Because I had brought this GoPro over, which I had previously utilized for my channel. And, you know, like, just whatever, hunting, skateboarding, snowboarding.
You utilized it?
I believe it was a 4th of July, like, weekend several years ago.
Like, how many several years ago?
I don't know, maybe, like, 4 or 5 tops.
'Cause that's how long it's been that it took him to forget the password.
Yeah, well, what the fuck? It's just a GoPro, dude.
Who the fuck knows? But I couldn't fucking access any of it, any of the controls, especially connected to my phone, without that and updating the firmware, everything like that. Now it's all updated. The only way I was able to do it was I had to get a mini HDMI cable, which I didn't realize I already had because I use it for the Samson QTU microphone.
Right,
but. Fucking messing around fucking when I was trying to fix my computers when I realized, because I unplugged everything, and I realized that wasn't mini HDMI. And I tested it, and it worked.
Yeah.
And so now the shit's reset, updated, got everything, got it hooked up to my phone too, so I can view the shit, make sure everything's the right angles, you know?
Now, riddle me this, Batman. Is there a way that I could also have that capability on my phone? Like, at the same time? Because, like,
I don't know.
You know?
I don't know.
Because, like, he's just commandeering my GoPro right now.
You told me to do so.
Stole my Hero 3, dude.
You told me to do so.
Stole my Hero 3,
You dropped it off here.
That was a birthday present for my parents, dude.
Like, 6 months ago. With all the accessories.
Yeah, and look at how long it took to get it up and running. One cord, which he had the whole time.
Yeah.
Doesn't care.
Yep.
He doesn't give a fuck.
Yep.
She's like, Hero 3, bro.
God. Yeah. Get it for, like, $30 on eBay.
Get one.
Probably should get more. We should.
Speaking of which, that's my follow-up question. Yeah, it takes the same cord as this, but what if we got to utilize them at the same time? Fucking did you get another cord while you're buying all these extra bats?
I have not. But.
Could be a good idea.
Came with a battery charger.
Yeah, but still.
Also runs a mini HDMI.
Doesn't the cord fucking... What if you got to plug the system thing into the computer, dude?
The battery charger cord. It's a mini HDMI to USB. But you know what else that battery charger utilizes?
Tell me what it utilizes.
Micro USB 2.
Micro USB 2? What's the difference?
As well.
Oh, yes. Okay. Well, if you grammatically correctly structured statements.
I'm sorry. I cleared it. You know, I made it better.
Right.
I fixed it. You know?
Remix.
Yeah, a little bit. But, so, I don't even need to use the mini HDMI for that. To charge it. I can just run it up with my regular USB-C.
Extra flex.
Exactly.
That you have. You
know, But that also means that now I got the cable, a secondary cable.
Right.
To hook it up to my computer with the GoPro.
You got Cartoon Network?
No.
Then you don't have cable, dude.
Damn, bro.
You know what I'm saying?
I don't have cable, you're right.
Tsunami, dude. Everything's on the internet these days, yeah, dude. Remember cable?
Yeah.
You guys remember cables?
No, all you need is YouTube.
We've got way too many cables. Right? Well, that's exactly what you need. And only since we've come out with the content that we create. Exactly.
Like, no, you don't need cable. You don't even need Netflix. No. Fuck all that. You know, the Amazon video, dude.
No, see, this is the thing. Is we know exactly what you want to see.
Yes.
And it is
obviously.
And we're just giving it to you.
Yeah. It's all it ever.
There's not... And we're giving it to you long and hard. It's because content is way longer than it should be. And it's really hard to watch. But like, either way, least we could say that.
I'm waiting for somebody to call us out for scripting some of this.
Dude, I wish I knew what a pen and a pencil was, dude. And a fucking little notepad, dude. If I had a notepad, I can't even read my own handwriting half the time, dude. And I fill out 4473s for a living.
Which is the best part, because the ATF also can't. I could have been a doctor, my dude.
That's what I'm saying, dude. Fuck them.
Perfect.
I could have been a doctor, bro. I'm just...
Yeah.
I could probably steal a prescription tablet out of the doctor's office... And just write like I normally do, whatever the fuck I want, prescribe the shit to myself, and get it, dude. I'm back out on the streets, dude. Trapping out the bando, bro. Fucking, this whole room will be covered in the microphone foam, dude.
All of the ibuprofens.
We'll have a brand new GoPro.
Yeah.
It'll be the Hero 37. It'll be, but it's probably the technology. How far are they along these
days? I think they're the Hero 10 or something that now.
Hero 11, Mabes?
Mabes, coming soon.
Maybe already out. Immediately
after we buy a Hero 10, then the Hero 11.
Pull up real quick the latest GoPro, because I'm honestly interested, because I think they've always, I don't know what they cost now or how advanced of technology that they are, but I feel like they've always been, okay, cool.
Creator Edition. Hollywood in your hand, dude.
That's for us. Dude, just come with a little tripod.
Hollywood in my hand, dude. It's sus.
Dude.
All the pedos. 5.3K 60 frames per second or 4K 120.
Yeah, dude.
That's nuts.
That could up the game.
With external mic and lighting on this mobile. Extended battery life.
Right. For how much?
$581.95.
Okay. Not awful. Too bad. Not awful, honestly, for what you're getting. No. But, like, what is, like, the base model? Just go. Like, we could probably get, like, a Hero, because, like, these are the useful 10, things.
It's your normal Hero 10 black, right?
Okay.
$399.98, $400. You don't have the external mic.
Still
4K? It is still 5.3K at 60, 4K 120.
How do you even? I don't even know what the fuck is 5.3K, dude.
I don't even know if there's a fucking screen that'll run that in this house. But it's got it. Better low light capabilities, dude. With 1 year GoPro subscription.
What do you mean with?
I don't know what a GoPro subscription is. I have no clue. But
they sent you a bunch of junk mail to your inbox, bro?
Yeah, exactly. We go to the Hero 9, bro.
Okay.
So get 5K video up to 5K what
is
video.
This is the first time I'm even hearing about 5K video. I know, shout out to the train.
I ain't even got 2K.
Shout out to the train, bro. I don't know if y'all could hear it, but shout out to the train. Not. Who cares? No, that's part of the video. It is. Fucking but... Thomas the Famous, dude. It was like, boop.
And then, I don't think they can hear the train, dude.
Dude,
I was trying to see if the fucking input would hit, but it didn't.
Shit. Yeah, what is the oldest GoPro here that they still support?
They got a Hero 8. They got a Max, dude.
What
maximum
is that?
Wow.
Maximum
360
wow.
360 degree footage.
Okay.
360.
That might not be. I got that. You listen, I'm
6K 360 video, dude.
Where are you coming up with these numbers, dude? How does this fucking? How could you? The ultimate first person
Hero 10 black
vagina.
Bones, dude.
What?
I don't know, dude.
The ultimate first person vagina? What is first person view?
Yeah, dude.
Of vaginas?
Yeah. You can use it for such, you know. I think they call it an OnlyFans.
It's waterproof for a reason. Is that. The Hero is. Because before.
So Hero is 8 is the last one they have here, at least.
So
on their main page.
Okay, but it's still an ongoing line. Because before, wasn't there originally like just the regular GoPro, and then the Hero was a separate line? That's what I remember. Now, GoPro's a bit... I used to skateboard and shit.
Yeah.
And so, like, that's where, like, all this fucking type of shit, like, when it first came out. Because in the grand scheme of things, these little GoPro cameras, mm-hmm. I was alive before they came out.
Yeah.
Right? So, they're not super old. No. But they're... a widespread in their usage for almost any type of different activity you could think of. But like back in the day, like the Hero 3, when I got the Hero, whatever the fuck it is, that was like cutting edge technology. It was finally, they used to be 720. It was finally HD. It was fine. You know, whatever the fuck. And I got all the little accoutrement for it. I got the waterproof housing. I got, and it's been underwater. I got the fucking, you know, the little, what do you call it? The bindle or the kindle or the gimbal, gimbal, whatever the fuck.
The kindle, the bindle.
I sound like I feel like I'm fucking, put me in a home, dude. Put me in a fucking home or take me out back and shoot me like old Yelly. Feel like a fucking boom, dude. What is that? The fucking internet you're talking about, kid? Like, what the fuck? Put me out of my miz, dude.
Dude, you ain't got a gimp, dude.
Dude, I fucking feel like a gall dang. I got a limp,
dude. You are
a
goddamn gimp, dude.
Get the fuck out of here. Faster, smoother.
They just get like 10 Hero 10s, bro.
Dude, for $800 a piece?
Yeah, dude.
It's fucked.
Extremely. But.
So, this is the thing, though, is like, we, like. And there's also, like, hella cheap, like, other versions of this. Like, GoPro doesn't, like, own all of the technol on mini cameras that are, like, action cameras. Like, there's other companies that do it. And for less months. Dude, the Hero 3 is still $169?
A pair.
How?
It wants to load on the screen. I don't know. There's 11 left in stock.
This is brand new off Amazon, dude? This is
apparently new.
What?
Yeah.
Off Amazon.
Off Amazon.
Dude, this is a collector edition. Dude, give me my fucking camera back, bro.
Black Surf Edition, dude. I don't know what the difference is. Probably waterproof. No, it just comes with the fucking waterproof. Heavy waterproof case.
I got the fucking waterproof case. What's the diff?
That shit's fucking bolted in and shit. This shit's just glued, bruh.
What do you mean it's just glued?
Look at the fucking fez on it, dude. Or the cam Porsche.
Yeah, but like, what the fuck? That's just...
I don't know, dude.
That's it's
probably
just
completely useless and pointless.
Also,
and
this isn't even the waterproof case.
Well, the waterproof case is just a different backing.
True.
Yeah.
Either way, I've never had a prob. This bitch has definitely been under watts several times.
It's the black one more, dude. One set, the black one's cheaper, dude.
That's racist. That's fucking...
like $40?
Why is the silver one worth more months,
dude? Why is... the picture's still the Surf Edition.
Is that for your wrist? Is that the control for your wrist so you could be doing surf stuff?
I believe so, dude.
Does it not work when you're skateboarding?
Apparently not, bro.
It's fucked up.
But 117. We can get GoPro Hero 3 Black Edition.
What about the Hero 2, dude? Is it even cheaper? Are they even a Vay?
I don't know.
But also, like, why... this has obviously got to be still... obviously, you found batteries for it. Where did you find the batteries for it?
On Amazon.
No, of course. But, like, what, like, is it, did it seem, from what you know, being more cultured in the technology realm of things, like, are these just common batteries that are used for other things, or are these solely
these are also
batteries?
Using for, like, drone cameras and shit like that.
Same exact thing. Yeah. This one just says GoPro on it.
Yeah.
Okay. That's good.
These might even be upgraded with higher milliamp hours, so higher battery capacity. But
so as far as obviously, because obviously, if they're already on the 10 and this is the 3, we're a little bit behind. A
little bit.
Only a little bit though. We're still catching up. We're still in the race.
With this, you get 1080p,
but
30 frames per second.
Right. So it's still high definition, but if there's a lot of movement going on, it's not going to translate as well.
Yeah.
But still, I mean. Some of my best and most successful YouTube videos are 1080p, 30 frames per second.
Yeah.
So, you know, whatever. And two, it's filmed on a GoPro, and you know it's filmed on a GoPro, And, like, it smudges and shit. But, you know, especially if we are using it for, like, if we're sticking it underwater to fucking give you a look at a fish, like, who cares what the, you know. But either way, like, the idea that it's now a capability to be utilized, which is awesome, and that's going to expand the content. It's going to expand just our abilities to be able to film different shit, even if it is subpar compared to this $1,000-something Canon camera.
Yeah.
You know, to get a different angle. Whatever. To get a different, plus taxes. You gotta can't forget about the infringement. Yeah. But the but yeah, it's this is another camera, and for content creators, that's always a good tool to have in the old toolbox. I'm gonna have to get one for the fucking pillbox, dude. I got the pillbox.
You do have the pillbox.
I got the pillbox, dude.
We talked about it last week.
Talking about Tarks, dude.
Yeah, dude.
Are you able to pull
it? Why does everything have to be related to Tarkov?
It's not, dude, but like this just so happened to be. I got the pillbox, dude, with me. And you're going to have to stay tuned. I'm not going to reveal everything. Of course, you're going to have to stay tuned. You're going to have to chime in on the Terribly Tactical channel for the initial impressions of this bag being worth $200 to protect my potentially thousands of dollars of stuff that I would be keeping in it because it's a hard shell backpack. So night vision, computer stuff.
Yeah.
And I bought it off Amazon. It was at my house the next day for $8 less than $200. I paid $192 something.
With tax?
Yeah. Because it's $180 whatever for the black one. And then I thought about getting the tan one.
Yeah.
Because it's cheaper by 10 fucking bucks. Yeah. And it's cool looking. Like, that would be a good Minuteman kit bag or whatever. Yeah. But, like, for everyday shit, it looks way too tactical. And at least in my opinion, scales bags to differ. But I think this looks less tactical as in the black configuration. I think it looks more like a tech bag. I think it looks more like a biker's bag. Like, somebody on, like, a Ninja or whatever, a Gixxer, like that, like a sport bike. Or, you know, just a normal backpack. Like, almost even, like a stylish style of backpack type of thing that somebody would wear just for the swag as opposed to, like, an actual functional thing. It screams that to me more than it screams gun, but that being said, it still definitely does look somewhat tactical, but I will argue this, you're seeing, yes, if not a few, but the... But and several gun accessories, but the fucking, but like the, like you're, this is, you're getting, Walmart carries Molly infused tactical backpacks. Yeah. They're junk compared to other things, but it is a tactical backpack. That's what I'm saying.
Fucking everywhere.
So does that even really matter anymore? Because in theory, there's people buying and using these backpacks that don't even know what Molly is or what it's for. They just think it looks cool or it's just a backpack and they have no idea and they're not even so in the grand scheme of things.
I used a fucking backpack with Molly in fucking junior high school, bro. Like, I just put pens in that shit. I just put pens in that shit.
Did you know what it was?
Yeah. But I shouldn't have any accoutrement attach, you know?
That's a good word. But yeah, dude, so this is in the game. In the game of Escape from Tarkov, which, of course, we've been gaming, we've been streaming. If you want to catch all that, make sure you check us out on Twitch. Make sure you check us out here on the Shooting the Poop podcast with the mini podcasting series
more professional
of Terrible at Tarkov.
Yes.
But also the Terrible at Tarkov stream on the Terribly Tactical Twitch, but also the Terrible at Tarkov Terribly Tactical B channel video game channel. There's just so many channels. Yep. Links in the description box
below. All Terrible Tarkov, it's all that we are.
Yeah. No, we really are. Yeah. But it's cool because, like, obviously being gun and gear guys, like, we nerd out over that shit. Yep. We like that shit. We appreciate that shit and how it works and its function and, like, well-made shit or well-designed shit. Like, I've been impressed with this bag. Like, this, it's for what it is, and I just got it, and I haven't even completely set it up or built it out. It's going to be way sicker when I'm done with it. But, plus, I got some shit coming for it, too.
Yeah.
I got some shit coming for it. I don't know if I could tell the people about it, but I got, like, different little shit, like, computer techie, but, like, still, like, useful survival, EDC style, you know, shit that, like, because this is going to be it. This is my dedicated, like, tech shit bag.
Yeah.
So if whether it's a computer, my laptop, we're playing Tarkov, we're streaming, we're podcasting, mm-hmm. or it's fucking night vision and thermal, because, I mean, again, it's a hard shell, it's very well padded, it's completely customizable, at least as far as, like, the main part of where you're putting shit, and I don't mind the organization that it has. I mean, you saw it, and you guys are going to have to stay tuned on the Terribly Tactical channel to see it as far as the reviews and how I have it set up, and I'll show you my, like, podcasting gaming setup, and then I'll also show you like my night vision fucking helmet fucking tactical setup shit assault pack setup or whatever it is, because it's actually a decent sized bag. I didn't know how big it was gonna be.
Thought it was gonna be a little smaller.
Yeah,
from the pictures.
But like it's a pretty good size bag, but it's not too big though.
No, it's not.
And it does limit you a little bit in the way.
I think it's even a little bit bigger than my day pack is.
I don't know. Maybe just because it holds its form. Because maybe. It's, you know, but like it's not too big to where it can't be a proper assault pack, but it's also like because of the way that it's set up, it might not be as preferred for certain instances. But I mean, I honestly, it does have its versatility in my opinion for, you know, like you could still put a pretty good amount of shit in this.
Yeah.
If you think about it, dude, like I could fit everything I fit in my EDC bag now, the Tactical Taylor Mil-Spec Monkey Collaboration Adapt Pack, everything I could fit back here. Yeah. All those individual pouches could fit perfectly back here. Yeah. Plus, I got a computer now. Plus, I got extra shit, fucking whatever. So, you know, I don't know. You know, I'm going to have to mess with it and set it up. I just got this. And
if I were you, at least,
what?
Is I'd make that the EDC and just EDC the laptop, bro. Take all that shit from your other bag, right? Is to toss that all into the fucking, into the main compartment. All your other little pouches and shit, right? Take the laptop side of the bag. You put all your cables and stuff like that in there. Put the laptop in there. Fucking in the backpack, like I said. Fucking stash the gun in there in a fucking Velcro holst. And yeah. The only thing is your headset.
I didn't even have a gun, dude.
No, you don't even own guns. Guns are bad. Guns kill people. Gun, no, guns kill people.
Why would I ever have a gun?
I ain't never seen a gun in my life, dude. None of them, dude. No guns. Guns are bad. Dude. It's a weird looking flashlight you got there.
Dude, it is a weird looking flashlight. Dude.
It is a weird looking flashlight, bro.
I don't think it's that weird looking, though, honestly, in the grand scheme.
I mean, for a flashlight, you know. It's pretty weird.
I mean, it's a cool looking comp.
It is.
From Faxon with their match grade barrel. And then there's the Streamlight TLR7 sub right there on the Glock 43X running standard mags because I don't trust the shield arm shit. That being said, I'm probably going to buy some just to mess with them, which means I'm also going to have to buy their fucking metal mag release, which means it's probably also going to wear down on some other plastic part inside the gun and then fail when I need it most. But I'm going to try it out for you folks at home because I've seen mixed reviews. I've seen people say they love them. I've seen people have problems. But either way, this is going to be a mini Roland special. I'm probably going to get the new Hollow Sun for it that is flush with the slide, doesn't need an adapter plate, and you could co-witness standard height sights through it with. And this will be a mini Roland special, which is basically a comped, lighted, dotted Glock 19. But this is the 43X. You're still getting that three-finger purchase on it, but it's more slender, little lighter, but at the same time, probably going to kick a little bit more, which is why with the comp on there, it's only maybe a quarter of an inch longer than a 48.
Yeah.
So it would be a proprietary holster, or you could bevel out the bottom, you know, Dremel out the fucker, whatever, which actually I should probably try that.
Yeah. Do you have a light bearing holster for that?
No.
Without?
No, I don't have anything for this because Harris Holsters does not, to my knowledge, make a fucking light bearing holster. I need a Harris Holsters custom rig for this.
Yeah.
Even if I got to send your ass the fucking gun, like, I need one of these, dude, because this is a badass setup, dude.
Yeah.
For what it is, because it's just small enough and light enough to be, like, rather handy where you could stash it anywhere.
Yeah.
You could carry it and conceal it no matter what.
Yep.
Even with the extra shit on it.
Yeah.
But it's big enough.
With everything there, it's smaller than a Glock 19.
Yes, and it's still big enough. and comped and whatever, and you got extra weight with the light,
yep.
and you got a full grip, that it'll shoot very similar to a 19. So these things are growing on me. I'm not a huge, because it's fucking, I did a whole video. It's coming out soon on the Terribly Tactical channel. You might already see it before you see this. Actually, no, because this is going tomorrow.
Yeah.
But I also might post that tomorrow.
No, you got to drop it tomorrow at like noon.
Right.
Or drop it at like 6. It's like, see, this is the teaser, dude. And then.
Yeah, but nobody's going to
watch it. No, nobody's going to watch it. I mean, we're only 30 minutes in. We might have 2 people watching still.
Could be.
Yeah.
But the fucking, the 43X, dude, is almost the same exact size as the SIG Macro.
Yeah.
This holds 10 rounds, and that holds 17. So I'm still going to take this any day of the week because I know this works.
Yeah.
Plus, it's going to be more compatible in the grand scheme of things because it's a Glock.
Yeah.
You know? But, like, that's why the... Because with the shield arms things, 15 plus 1, plus you can get Terran base plates, whatever. Mm-hmm. But if you can't trust them, who cares? The one thing I'll say about those SIG fucking mags, they're the smallest ones, and they do feed and work.
Yeah.
So, why the... I know why it is. It's because Glock refuses to get rid of the polymer coatings on their magazines. Which I get, because it works, and if it ain't broke, don't fix it. But you are also stifling your capabilities. Almost
every carbine uses Glock mags.
Right. So, this is the key to a semi-automatic pistol, is a good magazine. Yep. Like, obviously, the rest of this shit's got to be squared away, but if you got a crap magazine, like we saw with the Beretta, and was one of the reasons why the Beretta M992 got a bad rap, is because the military had contracted magazine manufacturing to a shit tier company because it was cheaper. And you guess what they got? Shit tier magazines.
Yeah.
And then everyone was like, ah, the Beretta sucks. But really it was Checkmate or whoever the fuck was making the Beretta mags. So, and same thing with the slides cracking. People were shooting the guns 100,000 rounds, never changed the recoil spring.
Yeah.
You know, they don't care. It's fucking not their gun. So.
And then you get the fucking Brigadier slides.
Right.
You know?
But
a little bit extra meat on it.
Either way, the fucking... I would still take this 10 plus 1 round gun that I know works every single fucking time, no matter what, over the 17-shot SIG 365 or even the Shield Plus or whatever.
Yeah.
Like, and because it's just... The first polymer guns that, like, I started buying seriously and shooting... because I was watching too many James Yeager videos, are Glocks. So I have a lot of time on Glock triggers. And, like, I'd rather shoot an H&K Hammerfire gun if I'm shooting plastic, but I'd rather shoot a Beretta M9 over that, but I'd rather shoot a 1911 over that or a revolver or whatever. So, like, to me, the Glocks are just... I'm starting to appreciate the fucking extra bullshit you can do to them. Yeah. Because, like, after you have however many Glocks... and you keep buying the same gun over and over again, so what, it's a different caliber, so what, it's a smaller or a bigger size. It's like, it's the same gun.
Yeah.
And that's what I hate about it. But, like, fucking with shit, you know, because it's I don't trust it. You start changing, it works how it is when it comes out of the box. But once you start changing shit, I tend not to trust it. So, of course, you can bolt the light to the gun. It's going to work. Iron sights on the gun, you have to get those. The stupid fucking Glock still to this day come with... They could come with the same sight picture.
Yeah.
I wouldn't even mind the ball in the cup.
No, not at all.
I would not, dude. Ball in the cup.
Yeah.
You know? Like, I would have no problem with that.
Oh, no, he dropped the ball out of his cup. Oh, wait, it's on a string.
Right, dude. Ball in a cup. But the fucking... We were watching Family Guy earlier too.
That episode was just the other day.
But the fucking,
for some reason, Shane never watched Family Guy.
Dude, that's weird. That's a whole different.
That's a whole other topic. That should have been a topic.
I don't know how Cheyenne has never seen Family Guy in her life.
I don't get it. Like, the amount of references that I've made throughout my life with her.
She just doesn't get it. She just laughs nervously
from Family Guy.
Feel bad.
And to realize she has never experienced them, and she has no clue.
I don't know how you guys are, like, who you are to each other, and for as long as you've been, have never come across this issue until like the other day.
The thing is, like, we've never just sat and watched like cable TV, right? So a lot of the times I'd watch Family
Guy,
but like a lot of the times I'd watch Family Guy because like it's the only thing on and it was funny. Like, it wasn't ever a go-to for me, really, you know?
Yeah.
Like, I wouldn't like search through and try to find Family Guy playing, you know? But it was on and there's nothing else, I'd be watching Family Guy, which is why I'm pretty sure I've watched almost every single fucking episode up until the point where I pretty much stopped watching Family Guy. But it just never came up.
These do fit the max perfectly, though.
Right? Yeah.
That's what makes me like having this.
No.
But I'm going to have to fix some, dude. I don't understand these small, tiny pockets.
My only thing is with that is to have the gun in the same pocket with minimal padding then against the laptop.
No, I know. The best way to do it would be to have it 100% here.
Yeah.
It would have to be sideways.
Yeah.
I'm going to naturally swing this around, grab it from here, reach in,
yeah.
Boom.
Yep.
But
I get soft armor on the front.
I didn't have time to do that.
Yeah.
But and I don't know. I'm not opposed to, like, this is a sick bag.
Yeah.
Like, I like this bag. Like, I'm thinking about even getting the fucking tan one to have set up for more, like, a dedicated fucking tactical or whatever.
Yeah.
But, and even make this in, like, a gray,
too. It's shit, bro.
It's like a fucking, what? They make a I didn't even realize, but the longer bag, the one of those longer, skinnier bags, is the Hazard 4 bag, too. And that's, like, their rifle shit or whatever. They got that, this is the pill box.
Bag,
and then they got the plan B, which is funny, because pregnancy and whatever, but like
the hibachi dude. Yeah, dude, the hibachi.
I love a good
little sling bag, bro.
Dude, look at that little tripe, dude. Maybe that guy's a content create, dude.
Maybe. Did you see that cam, dude?
Dude,
but also the tech,
he's got like a silencer on the fucking cam, dude.
Damn near, dude. That's really what it is, though. It's just, you know, incognito, dude. You know,
that's right, dude.
Should pull it off there, put it on his rifle.
Dude, look at that. I like how they are very open bags.
Yeah.
Everything that they make is like very accessible. Like, this shit clamshells out, but then even spreads open further to the side, it looks like.
And you still got your,
for gats and shit. And it's a hard shell, too.
It is.
So, it's...
What else they got?
Dude. They got all types of shit, dude. That little poncho thing is sick. I probably want to get one of those, dude. The fucking...
Yeah, sunglasses case, dude, to hang off your fucking...
Dude.
Put some eyes on there, dude.
Dude, what is this, dude?
Toiletry bag, bro?
Damn, dude.
Want a watch, dude?
Those watches are actually supposed to be pretty sick, and they're $574, so
yeah,
it better be.
Titanium tritium dive watch.
Yeah.
Yeah. There's one of the tie downs for your shit, so you can bolt some shit down.
Right.
You know, which what I was getting to with using that as an EDC is, like, even if you don't got space like your headset, you can tie that off to the top, dude. Fucking wrap up the capes, have the headset tied off there, have your fucking mouse inside of the bag, and that one
exposed to the elements, snag. Also, then they're like, I got a big fucking gaming headset hanging off the side of it, and I set the bag down for a second.
And why somebody set it down, dude?
I'm just saying, just fucking...
It's your gray pillbox, dude.
Dude, the gray is kind of sick, too. It's like a jean material, almost. It's
sick, dude.
But, like, yeah.
I think...
And it's got a different logo.
I think I might have to take the gray, dude. If I were to get a pillbox.
It's the most expense, dude.
It is. But, like, that is sick.
I didn't even see the gray as an option. I saw the black and the tan.
I know.
See, I saw the gray later after I bought the
fucking... I just don't really like how it's still tan on the inside and all three of them.
It's high-vis that way.
It is.
It's, like... it's a brighter, but not, like, super bright color to where it'll be contrasting to where you, even in a low-vis environment, you can still differentiate. So it's there for a reason. They used to do just, like, Vanquest.
Yeah.
Like, they do... Vanquest does orange. Like, super bright, high-vis orange on all the interior. Yes. So you can see what you're... even without light. Because you might not be able to have light.
It has a Ford nutcase, dude.
Like, the fucking shit, see, they got, like, battle belts and shit and different fucking, like, this is what, the go bag. It's cool shit. Now, that being said, and also no affiliation, Like, I paid my own hard-earned money for this shit. And I only really bought it because it is, like, known to be a techie, like, computer type of night vision, like, electronic type of shit, but still in the tactical realm and useful for both and both at the same time. And also because it's in the game. It's in Escape from Tarkov. It's one of the bags that I've gotten. I've scabbed, I've used, I've fucking, you know, I'm still using. Like, it's cool. It's just it's a collaborative thing. And it allows me to do cross-platform content. I could show the bag in real life and show it on the game, on the gaming channel. I could cross-platform it on the main channel, and then I get the both worlds combined. And they're checking out the real shit, they're checking out the gaming shit, they're checking. And plus, honestly, at least for now, I don't know how it's going to hold up. It could fall apart in 3 weeks. But it seems like it's pretty well made, and it seems like it's almost perfect for what I intended to use it for.
Yeah.
Because all I need is something that I could keep my night vision, my thermal, or my laptop in, like, you know, podcasting, live streaming, YouTubing equipment in, and have it protected and padded. Again, it's a hard shell, so it's gonna keep it like that. It's going to be water resistant. And it has, you know, tactical features. It's got MOLLE. It's got, you know, different attachment points. It's got concealed carry pockets. So, like, I could still have my gun. I could still have my meds. I could still have my whatever, you know. And so, because realistically, you know, obviously they've seen my EDC pack and shit. It would be a little ridiculous for me to take two backpacks with me. So maybe I'm a little light on some stuff using the tech shit when I need to use the tech shit, like coming over tonight. This is all I got. I don't got the other one in the other car or in the truck. I don't have the other bag in the truck.
I was surprised by that, honestly. I was expecting you fully to walk in with your other bag and that bag.
I thought about it, dude. But I was like, no, I got the glizzy. Yeah. I got the shit on my pizzy. And then I got my fucking compute tizzy, bro. Yeah. I'm out here, dude.
Yeah, dude.
Can't stop me. Plus, I got all this shit in the truck, too, all the time, too. I myself forget about all the shit that I have in the truck. I'll be in an emergency situation and have the tools I need at my disposal and think I left them at home.
Yeah.
That's the story of my life. But either way...
It's like the hand sanitizer.
Yeah. No, that was a conundrum, dude. We almost died from a pandemic, dude.
All kinds of tools.
Yeah.
To try to open a hand sanitizer thing.
I felt it about to break.
I was fine with breaking it if it need be. Let's get that motherfucker open. Even if I had to duct tape it back shut, it was coming open.
Yeah.
But all we had to do was pick it up instead of pushing down.
Right. We couldn't fathom it at the moment, though. It's beyond our... realm of
all this stemming
comprehension
from your leaking pod, dude,
which is fucked up and still an issue because I'm fiending for the nicotine, dude. I can't just hit this. Is this even a up to current date? Why is it smaller, dude?
It just is, dude. It's a Novo 3, bruh.
This is a 3?
Yeah.
I think this is only a 2, bro.
Bro.
But it's the newest
times,
thing,
dude.
Though.
Why are you behind the times, bro?
What do you even got in here, dude?
Berg, dude.
Would have the Berg, dude.
Mm-hmm.
This fits. This same is the same. This is the same.
Same size as the old one that I have. Fits the cut.
Why is it mermaid fucking purple and blue?
So when I drop it, I don't lose that motherfucker.
This is a dark color, bro.
It's not, dude.
If anything, reflective. I feel like OD green.
That is a reflective color, dude.
This is a reflective color. Look at it reflecting, dude.
Dude, hold up that one, dude. Look at the reflect, dude. It's
mine is way brighter.
Nah, dude.
Way brighter. Significantly way brighter.
I didn't have that call in the Novo 3, bruh.
Yeah, well, maybe you should have got a Caliburn.
Nah, dude, fuck the Caliburn. They shit-ass pods, dude.
It does cradle your lips nicely. But act like you don't know what I'm talking about, dude.
Homer Simpson.
That's very Simpsons predicting the future of me. But the fucking, you know, like that. Tell me it doesn't, dude. Look at the ergonoms on that.
It's definitely more ergonom pod, dude.
I feel like this bitch is burnt almost, dude. Look, you got a little brown shit coming off from the bottom. I actually, in some cases, prefer the burnt coils when they first start burning. Because, like, it adds a little bit of harshness to it.
A little bit.
But it doesn't disturb the taste as much. Yeah. But it lets you know, like, hey, but it's, I feel like you feel more, it's probably placebo and all types of mental shit that we have no idea what we're talking about. We have to get Cheyenne in here and she'd be like, you guys are just fucked.
Yeah.
But.
Precisely.
Also, how do I know that you don't have herpes? And this wasn't a setup.
I might.
That's what I'm saying, dude. Looking like yourself and shit.
I know, dude. I know.
Because you would be the type to accidentally get herpes from a public toy. Like, not... like, it would, and it would be... Well, dude, he never just, uses public toys. It
just so much, bro. Has, you know, I'm trying to take a piss. Yeah. It just smacks the seat sometimes.
His fucking... It's, the hair on his ass fucking acts as like a Swiffer. It's like and a just sponge. Gathers, it just gathers up all the fucking...
Draws it all in.
This is... That's a fucked up situation. You're not getting this back, by the way. Fuck you.
Shade, bro.
Dude, it's a health concern at this point.
Yeah, dude.
What else do they have, though? I feel like they... Because I would like to... If they have, like, a long... I want a really long... That's crazy that motherfucker's got a surfboard in his backpack.
Like...
Well, it's not really a surfboard. That? That's a bodyboard.
Yeah.
But still... Dude, that you can do. Yeah. So, is that... Do they have, like, a helmet one? I mean, I'm going to get the eagle one from T-Rex Arms.
Yeah.
But, I guess you could.
That's fully adjustable on both top and bottom.
Yeah, you could with that.
Yeah.
I just, like, I like the hard shell shit. Now, that being said, I tried, and I'm sure I could have done it if I didn't have the gun where I had the gun.
Mm-hmm.
But because the gun and the two mags, the extra mags, sit right there perfectly... Yeah. I just put it there for now. But I had the other laptop in that little sleeve, like, binder pocket. And, like, if I forced it, it could have closed, but I didn't want the gun smashing on the computer or whatever. And so I didn't. But in theory, you could even carry two laptops plus an armor pan.
Yeah.
So, which would be D's. And then, too, I don't know what...
What need do you have for two laptops?
I don't. I'm just maybe like a That'd mon, maybe a small mon or something. Dude. I don't know, dude. Small secondary mon, like I don't know. Plus, that would add to my ballistic protection. I would argue.
It would.
Robs. So,
to some extent.
Yeah, because I've shot computes, dude.
Yeah.
In the woods, you dude. Doing redneck science.
You have.
And like it stops buckshot.
Yeah.
At about 25, 30 yards, or whatever, maybe 50. I don't know what we're shooting at, but like,
I don't know.
It's hard to tell sometimes in the woods.
Yeah.
There's too many trees. You're like,
it's really like 5 yards.
No, it was definitely... It's
even more impressive.
No, it was... Well, yeah. But the fucking... I'm liking the idea of the heart. Now, again, like we said, this is made in China.
Yep.
And I still paid $200 for this at the end of the day. For a Chinese backpack. But that being said, just like the HoloSun shit, like, it's made in China, but it's pretty good quality shit, especially price comparative. Yeah. So, it just is what it is, dude. This fucking shirt's probably made in China. This mug is made in China. This computer that you're watching us on or your phone is made in China. Like, everybody had... Yeah, this shit. How long is this? Because will that fit a bolt gun? I need a bolt gun bag, dude. No.
No.
But still cool, though, nonetheless. Yeah. Is that one lower and fucking... Okay.
So that's a pistol. It's an AR pistol.
Right,
it looks like about a 10.5.
Right, but the last picture looked like it was one lower and two ups.
Yeah.
Would you say that's
might be a lower, an up, and then a full size? Nah, it's definitely another up on the bottom. Yeah.
Well, yeah.
Well, I was... If it was potentially a secondary full rifle, but no. Well, pistol at that point.
I mean, I guess really there's no way for us to tell, because in theory it could be, but no, not with the buff tube.
No. So, definitely a secondary up.
But decent, dude. You could run around with a fucking, maybe a full size up, and then a shorty up, and have the shorty complete, and then the full size up you could swap to or whatever. Yeah. Little Galdang 1911, dude.
Yeah.
Galdang, that's the best. That's what you need. They know what you need right there.
Corptura, dude.
And that's genuine the other thing, Cordura. Too. It's branded, genuine Cordura. They got the tags and shit. It feels like good quality material. Like, it's an extremely comfortable pack. I had scales tried on, and, like, you do feel the padding. Like, and it does seem to properly dispense the weight. You seem to have a concern about the laptop being on the exterior of it. But I don't know. I guess it depends what you're loading it out with, because in theory, other shit could be heavier behind it. But
like, as it's currently loaded out, it's definitely back heavy.
Yeah, but I think it's pretty well supported.
Yeah.
And I don't feel like it's pulling on me.
I don't know. I felt like
I don't think I've worn it long enough.
I feel like there was definitely less pressure up on your shoulders with that. It's more so on the front of your body than on the shoulders.
But I feel like that's good though, because like with the length of the strap that I have it adjusted to, like it's tighter than I would normally do it.
Yeah.
But when I have it just slung over one shoulder, it doesn't sag. It almost rides on my back like as if I had two on. And so I like that about it, because it seems just stable in how it rides, no matter how the weight displays or whatever. We'll have to save it for the review. But either way, like it's...
That's another thing, though. It's normally when I'm wearing a backpack, like if I'm actually carrying a bag, I got that shit tight as hell. Like, I don't want that bag moving on my back. But I wasn't going to adjust, mess the fucking adjustments on your shit. I keep fucking grabbing my shit to...
But I'm also... I mean, I'm taller than you. I probably got... Yeah. I mean, but, like, this isn't... Usually, I would have it looser than this.
Yeah.
At least to be able to get into it quick, you could always tighten it down.
That's normally how I run it. It's a fucking... On all my bags, I keep them fucking loose when they're off. Then as soon as I get them on, I tighten them.
But at the same time, most of the time on my bags, I'm grabbing out the house over the shoulder, into the truck, over the shoulder, onto the floor at work. Yep. So like I'm never wearing it where I'm.
Yeah, it's the same for me. Yeah,
you know.
But if I'm ever like when we go to iGold or something.
Yeah, right. You
know, I'm putting it on. I'm buttoning up the fucking chest strap and I'm strapping it down.
Yeah, right. I don't know. This does look like decent.
Proper backpack carrying technique, you know?
Right. But that's a long-term adventure, dude.
Yeah, dude.
But this is just a sling pack. So that's the other thing that I worry about is like, because in what, because this does look more tactical, of course. Definitely. And
it looks like a rifle case.
Right. So in what aspect would I be wearing this? Like, it's cool, because that's another thing too, is you get all this cool shit and it's easy to get the cool shit, find the cool shit, want the cool shit. That looks really cool. Do they have multicam black? Because if they got multicam black, dude, I'm buying it regardless. It
does not appear so.
But even the multicam looks cool.
Yeah.
But
you even have like a side carry handle on this.
Right.
And that's a rifle case.
Right.
There's no question about
that. No, I got my violin in there, dude. It's a Stradivarius. It's a Stradivarius, dude. Yeah. I'll have you know.
Yeah.
But the fuck...
Listen, dude. Can you use that in a sentence?
I have a Stradivarius in this gun case. But the fucking... you gotta switch things up once in a while, dude. Keep them guessing.
Yeah, dude. Yeah, keep all your black guns in the violin case and no violins in the gun case. You gotta have a violin in the gun case every once in a while, you know?
Just to throw them off the scent. But
I have to put a guitar in a gun case now.
No, yeah. Yeah.
Shout out to Cedarville Fine Fire.
Right. But that's the thing, it's so easy to get wrapped up in like this is cool, like this is cool. But it's also a functional thing.
Well, the thing is, like, all of the tactical shit is cool in one way or another.
And functional. Yeah. But as far as I'm looking at for that sling pack, I would like to have that sling pack. It would be another cool thing. It's in the game, and it's also a useful thing.
It apparently has it for selling walkers in ear protection.
With carbon fiber.
And I want to spend $127 on this shit right now.
Right, dude. That's the other thing. That's one of the things, dude, that I ordered to specifically have with the computer bag, dude, is another set of Bluetooth headphones with built-in mic and all that shit. And while they're similar to the ones that I already have and have been very successful with and enjoyed, especially for the $20 that I spent on them, they're a little bit newer, dude. A little bit more updated technology. Yeah. And a different color.
Do you need this for when we go fishing, bro?
Dude. I think you do, because I tied on the knots that you said I should tie on.
And you didn't lose shit?
No, I did. All right off easier than the ones that I...
Dude. Mm-hmm. Bullshit.
Mm-hmm.
Bullshit.
No, it happened.
You didn't lose a single one, dude.
No, I did.
Nah.
Stop encroaching on my mouse space, dude.
You don't need a mouse, dude.
Yeah, I did. Why is your
mouse in my space, dude?
Dude. Wish.
MySpace ain't even a thing no more. What the hell
is
it doing?
It actually is. We were fucking... I looked it up the other day, dude.
Just logging your old MySpace
account? No, I have no idea about what the fucking account is, but it does exist. It definitely does exist.
An easy way to spend $12 something stupid,
but useful, definitely be useful. Because under stress in a survival situation, like, you might fucking forget how to tie a simple knot that could depend on your life, dude, or your success in surviving and or thriving. Is that an IR beak, dude?
Appears to be a beacon light of some sort.
Yeah, dude. And that's sick. And that will bolt on to the bags. Yep. Not just this one, but several of their bags. But they have, like, these little areas right here. With, like, the fucking grommets and shit. And that, it's almost like an M-lock kind of thing, the way that it bolts in there. And it'll attach. They have, I've seen IR ones. This one doesn't appear to be IR, but it's got other shit, and it seems to be USB rechargeable or whatever the fuck. So, I think, like, it's just red LED. Yeah, so you could still use it to, hey, you know, follow me. Yep. Hey, this is where, you know, we're going to leave this at base camp. We're going to go off, try and do some shit. It's dark, but we'll at least be able to see that and find our way back. We're lost. We're trying to signal. LEDs. Yeah, whatever. Like, so, and it's sick, dude. It's sick that, like, they're incorporating that shit into, you know, because I haven't seen too many other packs. This is a whole frame you can bolt on with a whole extra exterior MOLLE compatible compartment that you could build out the bag from even there. Obviously, which on the also, side if is all MOLLE. Enough,
could be another easy place to stack a helmet. Fucking helm.
Right. You got the helmet on the outside. You got the components on the inside. Everything's protected. Fucking, you could even still have an extra armor panel in the backpack. Still be wearing a plate carrier with armor. Like, so, and it's all going to. The rigidity of it, the fact that it's a stiffer pack and a hard shell pack, I feel like, while it might perhaps limit the amount you could stuff it, you know what I'm saying? Because, like, with a regular expandable style, normal style pack, you could stuff it a little bit past what its normal dimensions are, and it's still perfectly fine. But,
as well as all of these mounts have the tie-off points, too, for shot cords, stuff like that.
Right, so, you can have more tripod, potentially, you know, a rifle with that rack on there. Yeah. So, you know, I mean, there's a lot of shit.
It's a sick-ass fucking bag, dude.
Yeah, dude. I liked it a lot. It really is. So, and it's cool that it ties it, because I've known about Hazard 4 for a while. Yeah. I actually heard about Hazard 4 through James Yeager. Yeah. James Yeager fucking was, like, getting shit from them. They sent him some shit, and it was, like, when they first came out. Same thing with, like, VanQuest or whatever. And VanQuest is sick, too. But yeah, the Hazard 4 shit has always interested me because they've always done it differently. Like, I mean, to an extent. Like, a tactical bag is a tactical bag, but, like, they seem to be a little bit more,
I don't know. Rotatable backpack?
Right. Like, right.
What? So you got normal, just normal backpack, but also can be a sling bag.
Right. Side. And then you've got your maps, you've got your admin, you've got your fucking little marker that you're drawing over the fucking, you know, it's all types of shit, dude. It's just, it's cool shit, man. And it's a little bit more money than some other shit, and it's still made in China. But again, it seems to be decent quality. We'll see how it holds up. We'll see how, you know, but it's going to get some use, man. Every Tuesday, I'm packing all this shit up and coming over here. And, you know, again, like, this is not a crazy fucking expensive computer setup, but it's still electronics. It's still, I mean, it's a $1,000 computer, you know, whatever, 50, 60 bucks on the mouse, whatever the fuck it is. You know, different shit. Plus the night vision, the thermal, whatever. Shout out to ATN. More content on that shit in the future. You know, especially this. There's all types of different little builds and setups I'm going to be doing. I'm still messing around with a lot of stuff, but I've been looking for a solution for a lot of that stuff. And, of course, there's the Pelican cases. I've got the Pelican cases and the boxes. But either they're, like, super big or they're not big enough.
Yeah.
You know, so, and
well, that's why
there's no organization.
Looking at all my cases and shit I got for the GoPro. So I want to set that up with all the batteries and shit, the chargers all into a case. I had a couple fucking hard cases. I got that big-ass orange one back there that's fucking that for a GoPro that's this big, you know, like, why would I do that? And I get the fucking,
unless you do it as the whole portable camera setup and you have it for that and the GoPro and everything else. All in one
but
thing.
But when am I taking that anywhere?
I don't know. Never. Might have to. Could be a good idea. At least we'd have fucking 4K video or whatever the fuck it is. So, I don't know how hard it is to detach and unplug.
I mean, it's not difficult to detach, no. But,
you know. But a tool in the old toolbox to be utilized, perhaps. But yeah, I mean, it's just that the whole thing, because then it always comes back to just like in real life and just like in Tarkov and whatever. You know, it sounds cheesy that like we keep relating to the video game, but if you understood the video game, you would understand what we're talking about. But
Tarkov is life, dude.
Right. But like the as far as like the stash and like the keeping shit stash and organizing your shit, we've talked about it before. We'll talk about it more in the future. And I've talked about it a lot on my channel and we'll continue to talk about it. But like we got all this shit. It's easy to have all this shit, want to buy all this shit, acquire all this shit. Which is all well and good. And you should have the shit. And you should have the best quality shit that you can afford. And that's going to work well for you. But it's real easy to buy the shit you don't need and spend more money on it and have it and be like, oh, okay, this is cool, whatever. But then, like, it's not really accomplishing what you need. And you could have got something better for what you needed for cheaper, whatever. So there's always
you always got to do research guilty. And shit. And, you know.
I'm guilty myself very much of buying a bunch of different shit that I probably don't need. I mean, but at the same time.
Full of SOE shit in the other room.
Right. But at the same time, though, like I bought this specifically. I was looking for a fucking laptop bag. Yeah. And I was even looking for, like, even a sling pack thinking I'm going to have my EDC bag and then just the laptop over the shoulder and then still have, you know, a concealed carry pocket in the back or, you know, whatever. And just, but it'd be like a standard laptop. And that's literally, I got on Amazon and I fucking typed in tactical laptop bag. And this was one of the first things that popped up. And then I was like, hey, Hazard 4, the pillbox. Like, I didn't even put two and two together. And I was like, holy shit. And then I had to buy it.
Yeah,
I had to buy it right then and there. And so, but it's ideal. And so just using that as an example, like there's it could be a fucking, it could be a plastic Ziploc bag that works for you for storing whatever the fuck it is. But
you have it to be waterproof, bro.
Have it stored. It have it on hand. Have it available. Have it with you. Have it protected. You know, that Ziploc bag will be mostly water resistant slash proof. I wouldn't want to throw it in the lake and then go find it later, but, you know, shit like that. Like, there's just the organization of everything, having all the gear, not buying extra shit you don't need, but having extra shit you do need. There's a fine line, and of course, live your life at that looks like me in the woods. that's me it, in the woods right there, dude. I look at whatever the sand people make noise. That looks like a sand person from Star Wars, dude.
I feel like you shouldn't be allowed to say sand people anymore.
Sand. What other culls they got? They got different culls, dude?
Multiple different culls, dude. They got, let's see. Let's go back to this, right? They got the black, right? Dude. Black 2020 version. It's a different form of black.
Okay. Right. Back in black.
The OD greens.
Okay.
The navy blue.
And from what I'm gathering from this.
Cody 2020 version.
Is this not only is.
And royal blue 2020
version. A packable poncho. Rain jacket, whatever. It's also a tarp to be built into a shelf. That's
what it appears to be.
Right. For $100.
For $100.
Made out of what?
Made out of soft-shell poncho material.
That's some tactical ass shit, dude. Yeah. That, in and see, something as simple
water
as that.
Water-resistant, breathable, soft-shell fabric. 84% polyester, 60% spandex. Liner is polyester.
Yeah, dude. So, I mean, something as simple as that. And, like, that can be accomplished. And in that configuration, you could use that bitch as a pillow.
Yeah.
So, it's just having shit. You have
any emergency inflatable pillows, dude?
Dude, I do.
I got a couple.
I do have a couple. And I have a couple emergency. I'm stuck on the plane. Fucking got the little neck rings and shit, too. But the fucking, like, even something as simple as that. Yep. Have this in the truck. Have it in the fucking, at the lake house. Have it in the boat. Have it in the fucking.
At that point, fucking toss that in instead of the secondary laptop in the fucking Hazard 4 pillbox.
Right, because if anything, if it starts raining,
yeah,
which this is supposed, this bag in and of itself is supposed to be relatively
water resistant.
Right.
Yeah.
But that,
that
you could have the bag and you protected from the water, dude. Protected from
the water. That's definitely big enough you could fit the bag underneath the fucking 100% with your ass.
100%.
Your calves may get wet in the back, but you know,
who cares?
You know?
Who cares? But like that, like that's the thing. Such a simple little tool.
Yeah.
You know, and again, fuck Hazard 4. Get something else. Get something. Oh, patch panels, dude. Are you kidding me? All the way around, dude. IR reflective patch panel. Fuck it. We could be in the fucking... We'd be look like fucking... Oh, dude. We're going to look like fucking... Dude.
You're looking like the Grim Reaper.
Dude, there, that's what I'm saying, dude. We all have to wear Jason masks in there.
Yeah.
But the fucking... Like, the whole idea of it all is, like, just simple shit. It doesn't... You could probably go... You could go to... You could go to Walmart.
Yeah.
Get a blue-ass fucking tarp for $5. Spray paint it black. Yeah. Cut the holes out in it.
Probably buy a black one for $7.
Right.
Save money on the spray paint.
Right. Or at Menards. Either way. The fucking... But, you know, it's...
Maybe even Home Depot.
And... But that's where it comes down to...
You can go to Ace Hardware.
Right. Right. Support those people. They're a smaller business. Yeah. They need the help.
They're charging you more money, but,
you know, they have less employees.
Yeah.
Probably.
That's even more of a reason for them not to charge more money.
Well,
less employees.
I like to think that their employees are more knowledgeable than your average everyday. Like, they'll hire
anybody. Nobody in Menards will help your ass out. You know. 90% of the people in Menards are still in high school, and they're all women.
Those are the worst.
Yeah, right? I know, dude.
But yeah, just the idea of having simple kit, like, because in the grand scheme of things, this is some fancy, fangled, tactical, high-speed shit. Between
this color and this color, dude.
Well, there might be some other different shit with it. Maybe different materials, different fucking pox, whatever. Because if there's a new version and an old version. But either way, for $100, you get the black one. You could always spray paint it if you needed to. Yeah. Like, I mean, it's fine. But, like, just the idea, it's something so simple, and yeah, you might be like, $100 for that, for a rain poncho? That's fucking ridiculous. I could go to the dollar store and get one for 50 cents. Yeah. And yes, you can, but do you have one? Do you have it stashed in the vehicle? Do you have one in your EDC bag? Do you have it in your go bag? Do you know how to improvise that into a shelter? Are you going to be able to have a pocket knife on your ass to drill little fucking divots through it so you could lash it to some cordage? Do you have the cordage with you? You could keep the cordage in the fucking pocket. So it's just an idea. If you're not going to have the shit that's set up for you, you have to set it up. Yep. And a lot of people skip that step. And so they might have the cobbled together. I got a little bit of this here. I got some of that there. But they've never put it together. It's not stored together. Yep. They're probably not going to have it together when they need it.
So we're just rednecks and we can put anything together and make it work somehow.
Right. But that's because of the thought process. Is you have to think that way. You have to be able to improvise, adapt, and overcome and figure out solutions to problems with limited to no gear. Even and where or... they
weren't really a problem in the first place, just like that hand sanitizer.
Right. But we were going to figure that shit out, dude. We weren't stopping.
We got it open before we knew how it opened.
Right. Right. And it didn't break, neither. It didn't break. Fucking, you know.
Quality kit.
Right.
So who the hell else has a hand sanitizer dispenser mounted on their wall in their house, bro?
Probably a lot of liberals.
Probably. At this point, yeah. I had that shit like fucking 6 years ago. He had it
before the scam.
Yeah, I had it before it was cool.
It was a preemptive prep, dude.
Yeah, exactly. It was really because that was my reptile room, so I had the hand sanitizer right outside the reptile room.
Because he's always beating his snakes up or whatever. Yeah. Just fucking just slimy little slithery fucking things in his hands.
After cleaning up snake shit and everything and handling dead rats, you know?
Yeah. Yeah, but you build an immunity to it.
Yeah, I mean, yeah, I did, but
who knows. I'm about to go fucking handle a dead rat in the back of your yard, dude. So hit the pause button.
Shit, bro.
That's what...
Yeah, dude, you should fucking buy an accordion sometimes. Just how you get an accordion.
What the fuck is the dish
Have you ever had an offer of somebody selling you an accordion, dude?
No.
So why would you have had the urge to buy an accordion, dude? I'll sell it to you, dude. Just don't tell Cheyenne. And you pay for a compute. But are you done playing with your dead rat, bro? Oh,
dude, that motherfucker was furrier than I remember.
Cool, because the accordion again.
You should have been recording.
What do you mean, dude?
What? We are
recording. We are recording.
Good, dude. I'm glad we are.
Talk about your furry-ass dead rat to play with my backyard.
I'm glad we're recording, dude. Once you finally get some quality content, dude, you only have to wait fucking 47 minutes and 93 seconds.
Nobody's going to see it still.
Nobody would have caught that. How many people caught?
What's
93
up?
Seconds would be over a minute and a half, dude, which means it would be 50 or whatever the fuck I said. This is, dude, OSHA, this is a fire hazard, bro. Dude.
What's the fire hazard, dude?
The fucking umpteen cords plugged into all types of different
cross-sectional shit. You're the one plugged into most of the shit.
This I can't help. this isn't even useful. I don't know what the
charging that
but this is time. this is fucking. But at least when I get home, I'm gonna have bats, dude. Like, what do you mean? It's a preemptive strike, like George Bush in Iraq. We got him. But this is I'm not even utilizing this. And he's got way too. These cords are way too long, dude. I appreciate that.
I was gonna say, do you know how many times you have commended the extended cords?
I know. Dude? Listen, I appreciate the extended cords, but like, when they're not being utilized at a
they
distance,
they definitely become a bit of an issue.
Yeah, dude. Like I could get snared, choke, and die in this messing with this shit, dude. This is a. I am
gives
too.
Me an idea.
This is the type of bullshit, and then we don't even. You need to install a 3D printed magneticized cord holder to the side of the mini fridge in the stew, so we have proper cord alignment, dude. Because otherwise, now I threw that over there. There's 37 other fucking cords. I don't know which one's which, dude.
It definitely needs to work with cable management.
Right, dude. At least get the little tie things, dude. Some rub bands, maybe. Yeah, dude. Plus, I feel like we should fireproof the area. That's one little fucking thunderstorm away from burning everything
down.
Nah,
dude, it's surge protector.
That was good. Nah, dude, but that fucking connection looks a little faulty, dude.
Nah, dude, it's all good.
Nah, right there, dude. It's already sparking.
It's all good, bro.
It's been sparking.
Dude,
it's like,
actually
nah,
lighting.
Dude. Yes.
Yeah,
it's part of the RGB system he implemented.
It's planned, dude.
Yeah.
I designed it like
that. It's insurance fraud is what it's not.
Dude.
That's what it sounds
like.
It has
to get a little expensive.
Right. But yeah, dude. Either way, I don't know where we should still smoke the Stokes, dude.
I just don't think it's a good idea.
Dude. No, not in here, though.
Yeah.
We should still smoke them. I'm going to smoke this in the truck on the way home. Just and be done by the time I get home.
Yeah.
Stokes, dude. Yeah. No, it's like, yeah. But the fucking...
It's like a fucking 2-hour smoke, dude.
No, it's not, dude.
Close to it. For a normal person, at least.
No, dude, you gotta fucking... Pair, see? That's what you got, and then you fucking...
with the break these out on the next fishing trip, bro.
Dude, on the next fishing trip.
Dude. Yeah, dude.
I don't know if you're ready for the next fishing trip, dude.
I don't know if you're ready for the next fishing trip, bro.
When is the next fishing
trip? I don't know.
We should have been on several
fishing
trips.
We've missed
multiple problem.
Fishing trips.
This is the fucking problem. Well, I've been busy and had shit going on. I'm sure you've been busy, had shit going on. No, I'm way more busy and have way more shit going on. I don't even have a kid. But the fucking... I feel like you've been doing some shady fishing stuff without me.
What do you mean, dude?
I feel like you've been doing
some shit. I ain't even been fishing.
Where's the fucking all the lures and shit you get? You
they're in the front, dude.
Fuck, why are they in the front, dude?
Because they are, dude. Because I haven't been able to put them in the tackle box yet. Got to reorganize my tack box, dude. Get too much shit.
I don't know if, much like many other things in life, I don't know if having too much fishing shit is ever enough.
No, definitely.
Or too much gun shit.
Well, the thing is,
or too much whatever.
When you actually can tie a knot, and you don't lose a lure every 5 minutes, it tends to last a little longer.
Lose a lure every 5 minutes. I'm the only motherfucker that has caught the biggest fish on this fishing channel. You got close. Yeah. A time or two, dude, but like a pound or two short sometimes.
I'm just letting you get a lead.
Get a lead, dude. What are you doing?
Helping
fuck?
You feel better
what
about
What are you,
yourself,
a detective,
you know?
Dude? Get the fuck out of here, boy. Mr. Magoo looking ass.
Just, you know.
Shout out to David Magoo out there if you're watching.
Still won't get any invites.
No. That's invite only.
Yeah.
And if he
got the invite to the Discord, bro.
He
didn't even join them.
It's shady. See, this is why, dude. We're trying to extend the branch of the olive variety, and it's you don't even take it upon it. You know?
If you would have gotten in the Discords, you
maybe,
know, talk to us
maybe,
a little bit more,
right.
You know, connect
in like
a little
more
bit more.
Private
you know?
Setting, we
could
see
who
you really
who
are.
You know,
right,
where we
dude.
Could trust you a little bit.
Right, dude.
You know? Especially since he's not even going to watch any of this
right
now.
Especially
dude.
Since he's not Canadian, because we just instantly trust Canadians.
Yeah, for some reason.
So, like, you know, I mean,
not
it's
even
just
knowing their name or how old
dude,
they are or nothing.
This
you know,
is bullshit. I'm getting fucking demonetized hella hard lately.
Dude, you're always getting demonetized.
Hella I know, hard. But like, it's not. I'm getting sick of it. Like, it's like, too much.
There's nothing lately about this. It's been 5-6 years
now. I know, dude, but it's just like, they can't just let me.
No.
Be,
no.
I can't just be chill for like a month or something.
No, dude. They know you'd become too powerful.
Every vid, dude. It might be, dude, honestly. Like, and it's not even because of my
it's
own
really
doing.
For the safety of their everybody own. Else.
Right, dude. I'm a danger to myself and others, yes. Apparently.
If you're left unchecked.
Dude, you... look, they got the holster. I gotta buy the holster now, dude.
You do, dude.
What kind of guns could you fit in that, dude?
Dude, all kinds of guns, dude. What kind of guns?
$12.95, and you know what? Doesn't take 8 to 12 weeks.
That's true, dude. One day. Prime one-day delivery, dude.
Full-size 1911?
Yeah, dude.
Should be able to fit a glass. Oh, look at it. You know, that's the other thing I got to get, too. I got to get anchor bats.
Yeah.
I got to get more dedicated, because I have some and shit, but they're all spread about. I want to get dedicated, brand-new ones. Because, riddle me this, Batman.
Yeah.
Like, without getting some crazy fucking... I mean, I don't know how big an anchor bat gets.
Yeah.
But, like, are there anchor bats out there that could power this while gaming for at least a few hours that aren't huge and thick? Giggity. That's what they used to say about me in high school.
Lost a lot of weight since then.
You're getting quicker, dude. You're taking on my own asshole persona. I appreciate it.
There you go. That's the one you want, dude.
What is that, dude?
18.65 in that motherfucker. There you go, dude.
I don't know, dude. It's a Shark Geek. That looks like a bomb.
Straight up.
It's like a fucking bomb, dude.
Straight up.
And me walking around with that is the last thing I need to be.
It'll power your laptop, bro.
But for how long, dude?
5 minutes, perhaps.
Before it blows? At least have it like a little James Bond tactical counter. T-minus 5 minutes and counting.
Let's see if we can actually find fucking Anchor's Amazon over here. Is that...
Why? What do you mean?
Be the best bet to find some shit, dude. There you go, dude.
I can't. Just, that's not gonna fit in the pill box, dude.
Why not, dude?
I need a tablet-sized fucking... Should I be buying nothing but Anchor accessories, or is it much like Alienware or Alien whatever the fuck?
Anchor is, I would say...
Because I have many of their... Listen, this is where I'm coming from. Yeah. I have many of their products and have throughout the years. I've used them. I've never been let down.
Yeah.
But I don't necessarily have anything much to compare it to.
Yeah.
So, is it... Much like Alien gear or Alien, what is it called?
Alienware.
Yeah, Alienware.
Yeah.
Don't buy Alien gear holsters either, please. No, don't buy it. It's not.
No.
The shapeshift, what are you, a lizard person? Get the fuck out of here. But, so Alienware, like, a lot of people say that as far as, like, gaming computers or whatever, it's overrated. You're paying for the name.
Yeah.
Is that the same thing with the Anchor shit? Because, of course, all of this shit, I'm sure, is made in China and whatever the fuck else. So what's the difference between this and something else?
Anchor is definitely a reputable company. I did quite a bit of research on, like, the small portable power banks, like the ones that I got, which are Anchors. And I landed on the Anchor because for the price, you get a higher actual, like... storage capacity on your batteries on the power banks. For the size, it's a much higher storage capacity on the batteries, as well as I was looking at other reviews.
Wear out quicker though?
No, not necessarily. At least still you're gonna have, you know, diminished returns through age regardless of what batteries you're using, right? But Anchors are known to last longer. They have warranties and shit that come with them, all sorts of crazy stuff. And a lot of the other reviews that I was looking at is people actually buying the power banks, charging them full charge, and actually testing the capacities.
Right.
And a lot of them were, like, way under what they were saying they were supposed to be.
Which is very similar, like we see ballistically speaking, on especially defensive loads. With, you know, let's just say for your carry gun, you get some Hornady versus some Federal versus some Remington versus some Winchester versus some Fiocchi versus some Underwood versus some Corban versus some Buffalo Boar versus whatever. Only a few of those companies I just named are putting the real numbers that they get off the chronograph on the box. And that's because they've earned them. A lot of the other companies put theological numbers, potentiality of numbers, perhaps in specific perfect conditions or whatever, but realistically what you get is much less. However, you're paying the same price for that, if not more in some cases, just because of the name. So, I like I said, I've never had any problems, but again, the equivalent of me, most of the time, I've probably got 5 or 6 of the same size ones that you got, maybe a little smaller, some of them, by like the next size down or whatever. And every 3 to 5 months, dig them out, recharge them all, put them back in the fucking thing. I don't know if they're going to be good when I need them. Like, I don't know how I've had them for years. Yeah. Like, I don't know how that works, dude. I have the one, well, I don't have them with me now. I got to get some more. So that's what I was talking about. I was going to get some new ones to have in this, and then probably for all my other shit too, because I don't know how that works, because rechargeable shit obviously has a lifespan on it, which does suck. It's nice and convenient that it's rechargeable. Same thing with the handheld flashlights. Okay, so this Thrunite T2, excellent flashlight, super fucking bright. Like, it's got all types of different modes and features and shit. It's very bright, and it's very powerful, and it's rechargeable. I could USB plug this in. I could charge it right now. In fact, I think I'm going to do that, because this fucking bitch drains real quick from using it, because it's 3,500 lumens on regular fucking mode on high, and then it goes to like 3,750 on turbo or even brighter than that. And so, like, it's always on red. And then I've never seen this bitch green. I don't know if it goes to green, but blue, usually, when it turns from red to blue, I think that it's good then. I don't know. I don't know, dude. Have you ever seen another color other than blue?
I don't think so.
On a through?
No.
Blue on a through, dude.
You know what turns the bats even worse, though?
What?
It's when it turns on your pock, dude.
Yeah. And almost burns everything down. Yeah,
exactly.
I've had this turn on in my pock, but that's why I specifically orient the button with the clip. So it's facing outwards, so I'm less likely to fucking...
Yeah.
But at the same time, I did that after having not done that and almost burning the shit or blowing the end of my... Because, like...
But fuck Olight.
Yeah. Well, listen, this thing was hot enough... Well... Freeze your shit in a fucking thing for over a month and then fucking smash it against the concrete. We'll see if it still works, which it might. But until you do, we don't know.
Yeah.
This did. So if it does have any problems, which it hasn't.
No.
But, I mean, it's already, I would have expected for the money, its lifespan to be over.
Yeah.
So that's why I have to give it to him.
Yeah.
Whether I like it or not, whether it's China or not, like, you know.
No.
But who knows? Because you were even saying, too, and like I was saying with the Anchor shit, is the batteries, like the rechargeable ones, for after so long, you can't keep recharging them. It's like the laptop that you have to keep plugged in for it to work.
Yep.
Isn't there danger in that? Like maybe in this configuration with like an 18650, protected, unprotected, I don't know. But like for like an Anchor battery, like obviously it wouldn't work or wouldn't hold the charge, but like how many charges, how many uses will it take to get there? And then two, how long does it really store that power? I assume when it's brand new, freshly minted off the factory floor, maybe it holds full power for a year without a charge. And then after you've had it for a little while, you've used it, you've charged it, recharged it, whatever.
So maybe it's like only 6 months. Month on average, you're losing about 15% of your battery off of 100% charge.
Beyond fresh ass bat.
With a fresh ass bat. Right off the bat, it sits for a month.
You're losing 50%.
Right off the bat, you're losing 15% charge within the first month, right? Beyond that, though, the drop is very minimal. You're not going to lose much beyond that.
Why does it lose that over any period of time? The way that it does?
It's, I don't know exactly. I don't understand it.
I would feel that the lower the charge, the quicker it would lose its charge because it's straining more to keep up with whatever it is. Or, you know, even just, know. You know, I don't know.
I'm not a chemist. Science, you know?
It's rocket surgery, bro.
Yeah. But, and this might be your solution, dude.
What is this?
It's a portable power bank by Ankh.
Dude.
Right? It's an Ankh bank, dude.
It's... Keep it next to my spank bank.
Yeah, dude. But
the Ankh, but it might come in handy. That's a three-way triple entendre if you think about it. Most people are
especially depending on what you're watching.
110 volts, dude.
Yeah,
and they got the DC, dude, in case we're in France or whatever the fuck. On and off. It's gonna feature the You know? Oh, okay, man. So riddle me that. How big is this, though? Because this looks like it's a little keychain mother grabber.
No,
but I bet it's a lot bigger. Well,
if you look
at
compared to the outlet, right? That's the only real size comparison I'm seeing. Okay, otherwise, right. they have it like, you know.
Okay, that's like a fucking.
Like there.
That's like a 60 lumen camp flashlight.
Yeah.
Quite literally. Yeah. Yeah. So next literally, to it. Yeah. Fucking from the 1990s.
But like.
That's a toaster.
Look at about like a brick, you know?
It's a toaster. Where am I going to put that in the backpack?
Your bottom section of the fucking bag.
I don't know.
No. Heavyweights towards the bottom right there. The fucking inside of the fucking
but
the
I don't think that's going to... I think it's going to be... I think the depth is off with that. I think that's a little too big, dude. And plus, I'm not realistically... I just need some emergency shit. Like
well, said you wanted to power your laptop for hours while gaming.
Yeah, like 2-3 hours. Like, I don't... Like, just in case I had to, I'm stuck at the airport, fucking whatever. No. You know... It doesn't
need your laptop
this,
the power.
This you could fucking airport, probably
you plug it in.
You could probably fucking run people's cable off that for the entire town, it looks like. Fucking that shit is intense, dude.
You have 2 to 50 hours for a table lamp. Between 4 to 100 watts. You can power a mini fridge to 2 to 5 hours. 21 to 31 charges on your phone, 3 to 6 charges on your laptop, 7+ charges on a tablet.
What is the 3 to 5 hours CPAP shit? What is that? Oh, for a CPAP machine?
CPAP machine,
okay,
yeah.
That's what I figured. But that looks like a vagina, dude.
It does.
Why is he using vaginal looking? That looks like a vagina with a little tiny peen going in. That's what
you know exactly
3 to 5 hours,
like, don't
dude.
You?
Yeah, dude. I'm very familiar.
I don't know if they have like exact dimensions on it anywhere, though.
Because that's basically like that shit that I have from, what was it, dude?
The Jackery, dude.
The what?
The Jackery.
The who?
The Jackery, dude.
No, dude, from the fucking...
Where did you get that shit from?
With the dog, dude. I want to say it's not Survival Outfitters, but it's... feel like an asshole, but I totally forgot, dude. But they have like a dog, and it was like the waterproof bag that came with the whole fucking internal shit, and I got the
first dimensions.
Okay,
so 7.48 inches long, right? So 7.5 inches long,
giggity,
5.5 inches wide, and 4.5 inches tall. That's not that big.
That's what she said
to you. Could definitely fit in that like bottom section of your fucking
It definitely I don't know, that's a big looking bitch, dude.
That's a different one.
Either way, but well, yes, that's not how much is it?
Not cheap.
What is not cheap?
But not too bad.
No, that's that's for what that is, that's probably worth it. But I have the
my two battery banks were fucking like $60 a piece. What's the little ass motherfuckers, so
what is it, dude? That's gonna fucking kill me, bro. The fucking name of that outdoor...
But I think as far as what you were looking for, that's gonna be like your best bet though.
What?
Is this anchor one?
No, dude, like I need, like you could 100% do it off like one of those little tablet things.
Where are you plugging your computer into one of those?
You can't.
With your AC out.
You can't fucking USB it or into bro. That bitch, dude.
I don't think so.
Why not?
Fucking, because you got a fucking USB to DC adapter, dude.
But this is stupid, dude. What's with this fucking bullshit? You could charge a tablet with a phone cord.
Yeah. You got much smaller batteries that aren't as high of capacity.
Well, I have that other... What the fuck is the name of that company, dude? I gotta get on my own... This is gonna kill me, dude. This is gonna
get absolutely... Get on your own links tree.
My own Shan, dude. And fucking see... Always encroaching on my fucking mouse territory, dude.
Dude, why is your mouse territory? You gotta be so large, bro.
Oh, God forbid there's an actual ad.
I feel like, if anything, you're encroaching on my mouse territory, dude.
Dude, you have all the whole desk, dude. I got this little section right here, dude. Dude, what the fuck is the name of this fucking... With the gray bag, dude, that they sent me with the interior bag. They're fucking... Oh, here. Uncharted Supply Co. Okay. I knew it was something, dude. So they sent me their emergency survival fucking whole kit thing, and it sent me, I have that, the Zeus, dude.
Yeah.
That's what I have, dude. Which is, if it could jump a car, bro.
Where are you plugging it in, bro?
Maybe that's not, I don't know, I think that's what it is. No, it's the Athena. That's what I have. The
Athena, dude.
Yeah, that's what I got.
16,000 milliamp hour portable jump starter.
But you could charge your phone and tablet or whatever the fuck off it. I mean, is that Dees? Like, I mean...
This is a 57,600 milliamp hour.
What was the other one?
16,000.
So, man. It's in the game. It could jumpstart my truck charge my phone how many times?
And so the thing with these, though, is all your jumpstarter packs, the primary reason for their size and everything like that, they're not as efficient size to power ratios because their primary point is to get the higher voltages to start your car.
Yeah, but this is also a bunch of other shit, though.
Yeah.
Like, I don't know if you can
click on it. Like, they dropped shit. This is all the information they give me other than buy now. Damn. Yeah.
And I gotta have some. But the fucking...
Buy now.
Oh, there we go.
There's some information. Why do you have to hit buy now?
That's how they get
the information, bro.
But like, it's a flashlight. It's a fucking... It's all types of different shit.
Yeah.
So it's got...
I've had a couple of these.
The Athenes?
Not the Athene exactly, but... Yeah, I actually had an Anchor one at one point.
But I mean, you could
plug it... But it got stolen out of my truck.
Shit.
Yeah.
Yeah, I don't know, dude. I mean, it seems like a decent enough spec for what it is.
Yeah.
But, yeah, I don't
think that's where you're looking at is a dedicated, this is the job. While it does have the other functions, it's not going to be nearly as good as those other functions.
What is she doing?
She's charging a very small notebook-style laptop.
I got a USB whatever the fuck plug on this bitch.
Yes, but it's not a charging plug.
But it should be, though. Why is it not?
Because it's a data plug instead.
I'd like to have some fucking data in the form of electricity, dude. Electrical data, dude. Which isn't that what it all is, dude?
This is one of those things where, like, it's a great jump pack. It's also a flashlight and a phone charger.
Yeah. Which is good for emergencies.
Yeah.
So again, it's not, that's why it's like, it's not, there's nothing smaller than that anchor thing. Cause I feel like while it's, I feel like it's still kind of big. I feel like that's bigger than you think it is in real life.
I don't think it is, dude.
I think it's a little bigger, dude. Cause like, does that handle lay flat ever? No, it doesn't look like. No. So that's adding a lot more fucking. So
the thing is like, that's a deck of playing cards right there, bro.
That's a way larger than normal deck of playing cards.
No, it's not, dude. That's a box of matches, bro. It's two boxes of matches. Those flood lamps you saw are actually emergency D-cell lights.
Like, there's two jugs of water, and I think, is that a bunch of fucking salt and pepper shakers, dude? It
appears as if.
Why is that part of
something similar?
Why is that an emergency?
Dude, you want bland-ass food in an emergency, bro?
That's a good point.
Exactly. You ain't got seasonings in your preps, dude?
I got hella C's in the preps, dude, but like, I don't...
It's your lantern, dude.
What is this, dude? That's a can of tune, and this is some frosting for a cake, dude. Yeah. That's what it looks like, dude.
Or a small can of cough.
Yeah, dude.
You know?
The boom box, dude. Shout out to the boom box, dude.
That's a pretty small bat. For its capabilities, at least.
So, this'll... How long will it... So, it's full charges.
Yeah.
So, but like, I've never played Tarkov on this computer without...
Without being plugged in.
Right.
Yeah.
So, I wouldn't even know how long that would work.
Well,
probably an hour.
Potentially.
So, like,
let's see. Do we know what size your bat is, dude?
I have no idea.
I know I fucking sent you the link to that shit on here. I don't know. It was from my Instagram or the Shit and Poop podcast. Definitely from the Shit and Poop pod.
Which is where we are right now.
Yes. Well, I'm logging into my Instagram. Although not my Instagram, but my secondary Instagram. Our Instagram.
Which you also never post to.
Damn straight.
Come on, dude. You're going to scratch my new computer, dude.
Yeah, dude. Fuck out of here with that, dude.
What, dude?
Fuck out of here.
I'm measuring stuff, dude.
Nah, dude.
I'm just trying to measure right now, bro. You see this fucking thing? This is what you're doing to the conversation like right now, dude.
It's floppy.
Yeah, I would hope so. You fucking... What are you, homosexual? Why are you not floppy right now, dude? You fucking...
About 43
inches, dude. You gay fish.
You're about 2 inches right now, bro.
Yeah, right.
Get that much reach.
Get the fuck out of here, boy. Not even with the extension cord.
Trying to see if it says what size bat you got, dude. No, it just says it's a 4-cell lithium ion bat, dude.
I mean, it seems like it's an okay bat, though. Although the game starts tripping when it's low on bat, and then I feel like it's like something that like the game's tripping or something's tripping, but it's not. It's just because the bat's like dying.
Yeah.
Because I forgot to plug it in. Yeah. And like you do, you get weird like lines across the screen, and then you get, it starts lagging and shit.
Let's see if the Google has an answer. You have a 90 watt hour bat.
Is that decent?
Yeah, pretty decent bat, dude. But this says you get 3 to 6 charges on a 35 to 65.
So I get one and a half.
You get about
two
charges, yeah. Pretty much. Yeah.
So that's not even worth at that point.
I mean,
whatever. How many charges out of the phone? Like 30?
21 to 31.
And that's a 0 to 100 full charge.
Yes.
But there's so many different phones, and some phones take more charges than others. Yeah. How do they?
That's why it's a range of 7 to 10 watt hours on your battery size. Like all these. And so they measured it at, if that's your output.
Mini fridge. I love how the mini fridge is that important,
dude.
That they incorporated into the statistics.
Is it not impressive that this little battery will run a
mini
fridge?
Yeah, but at the same time, this mini fridge that I'm currently utilizing right now, dude, yeah. I don't know what you have it set at, but it's Luke Cold at best. It's almost a country singer. Like, this motherfucker is not... It's singing sad songs about how its coldness left it.
Yeah.
Because it's not... I don't know, you got it on a... These people in this household don't like cold drinks, apparently. They don't use ice. I'm the only one that uses ice in this household, I feel like.
Yeah, pretty much.
Which is weird to me.
Because that's what a fridge is for, to make your drinks cold.
No, dude, then why do you have ice makers, bro?
Because you'd be using
ice. Why wouldn't you want them extra cold? Why would you just want normal cold instead of the coldest?
Cold.
This is cold. Don't need to be that cold. Ice, willing to sacrifice.
Why you gotta be so cold, dude?
Why you gotta be so real? But you know I like Mountain Dew.
Yeah.
Not sponsored.
But so I got two cases of that shit for you. But it's almost all gone already. So I got a 2 liter up front for you.
You've been drinking that shit.
Bullshit.
You've been drinking.
I can't be drinking that fucking Diet Dew, bro.
I don't know why you don't be drinking Diet Dew. Diet Dew, honestly, listen, I'll tell you what. I will concede to the fact that it's not as good as regular Dew.
Yeah.
By a far stretch, right?
Yeah.
I think it's good enough for being a diet version of it, though.
I disagree.
And when you're mixing it with alcohol, when you mix alcohol with regular Mountain Dew, you're still affecting the taste of the Mountain Dew. So you're not getting the full Mountain Dew experience because now it's Mountain Dew and alcohol. So you might as well be using Diet Dew because then you fucking got less sugar. You're not going to be as hungover because sugar and alcohol, which alcohol comes from sugar, but like sugar and alcohol like dehydrates you worse. You get more of a hangover. And it's unhealthy. But so is diet, dude. You get the cancers from the aspartames of the fucking diet, dude. So who knows? We're all going to fucking
die.
It
kills the bacteria in your gut and all that shit, so you don't digest the shit as easy.
What?
The aspartame.
Yeah.
Yeah. But at that point.
Yeah.
It's 3 o'clock in the morning.
Dude. It is 3 o'clock in the morning.
We still have to fucking shoot.
Speaking about digestimating. Digested fucking. What are we talking about? The shit, the bacteria in your gut?
Yeah, yeah.
Somehow I was going to link that together with the Shooting the Poop podcast.
Okay.
But make it up for yourself at home. And leave it what in the you comments. Think I was going to say in the comment section below.
Or your own spin on
right.
it. You know,
we love you. We appreciate you. Make sure you tune in to all the relevant shit. Links in the comment section, in the description box below. Check us out. Terribly Tactical Scales. And you all. See you on the next one.
Maybe.